Thai is the art of war. You use 8 weapons: the hands, the elbows, the knees, and the feet. But the most powerful weapon of them all, the spirit.
Everybody in the world, they love Muay Thai. They love to see the culture, the fight, you know, the art.
That's real Muay Thai to me. It's not just getting up there in the ring and fighting. You know, it's how you are outside of the ring, as well as how you are inside of the ring, showing that respect.
I was asked to be cast in this film that they were making called Bloodsport, about all the different fighting and martial arts that were being put together. It was the beginning of the mixed martial arts revolution. It was after that movie that people started recognizing Muay Thai, you know, as the most feared stand-up sport on earth.
People are always asking me, why don't you do some MMA or some boxing, you can make a ton of money. Yeah, but I don't love it. I'm not passionate about it.
When they promoted MMA and UFC, born in Brazil, and it's called Vale Tudo, but when they brought it to America and they tried to promote it, they called it mixed martial arts. Had they promoted the UFC as Vale Tudo in the US, people wouldn't have turned it on, because what the hell's Vale Tudo? You know, when the average American sees Muay Thai, like, what the fuck is that, you know? Muay Thai, you know? It's almost like attached to like this church atmosphere of it. No, I don't know if church is the right term for it, but like this cultural aspect of it being in Thailand.
Keeping true to the sport, I think, is extremely important. Traditional Thai, and then not trying to make it some American thing.
I think in the beginning they were trying to push it as a Thai sport. I don't know if Americans can deal with the Thai music going during the fight.
Before you fight, we have white crew or Ram Muay, you know, like Thai dance.
Ram Muay is when you start your spiritual journey, moving in the ring.
I can't watch a fight without the music now. It's just kind of ingrained in me. It's pretty boring without it, but if you see a guy that's never seen the fight before, they hear the music and it pretty much freaks them out.
When I was in Thailand, I remember talking to the trainers and being like, you know, what countries do you think are good? And they're like, you know, Holland's good, France, England's okay, Australia's good, Canada's okay, America's no good. That shit pisses me off. You know, that shit bothers me that we're not, you know, being represented very well.
I want to push Muay Thai to go everywhere, especially in America. People like love to see Thai boxing. I think nearly 10,000 people, half Thai people, half American people.
What makes this different and a few of the others is they're putting on fights that are competitive and that are, you know, world class.
And M-One is bringing in high level guys. They're putting on phenomenal shows, and they're putting on shows that are changing the sport. You know, Kevin's fight with Sanchai was probably the most important fight I've seen in years for the sport. It did more for the sport in one night than, you know, hundreds of other shows. A lot of talent that could come back to pro Muay Thai if there was just money for it. You can't really argue with guys going into MMA when, you know, they can make $50,000, $60,000 for a fight. You get a world title on Muay Thai for $5,000-$6,000.
I didn't start Muay Thai to be some world champion. I didn't do Muay Thai for the money. I fought to learn.
So many people are just getting enough Muay Thai to go into MMA, and you got the announcer saying this guy's a good Muay Thai striker, and he's just flopping around, throwing these net stupid things, and that's good Muay Thai, huh? And it's just a real bad representation of the sport.
It's not American Muay Thai. You know? Kevin Ross, Romie Adanza, Joe Schilling, those are the top guys in America right now. We put on fucking shows every time.
Another thing that hurts us bad is that on a lot of these cards, these promoters aren't bringing in the best American Muay Thai practitioners, you know what I mean? They're bringing in who they can get for cheap, and who they can get, who know can get smashed out and not make their people look bad. They don't want to bring me over there, they don't want to bring Joe Schilling over there, and they sure don't want to bring Romy over there.
Any one of the three of us could be the main event on almost every card in the US right now.
Maybe the world's gonna see American Muay Thai in a different light. You know, we start winning world titles and beating the Thais and are competing with the top Thais. You know, it's really gonna change the perception of Muay Thai here in America.
ก็คือรู้สึกดีที่ได้มาเป็นตัวแทนของประเทศไทยแล้วก็เป็นตัวอย่างของน้องๆในประเทศไทยก็อยากทำให้มันออกมาดีครับ To fight a Thai here in America is pretty cool. Till recently, Americans didn't see too many Thais fighting out here. You know, we just hear how great they are.
The Thai fighter today continues to be the best fighter on the planet.
ความภาคภูมิใจครับที่มวยไทยคนไทยเป็นต้นกำเนิดของมวยไทยครับ
Love being able to fight the Thais, you know. I mean, the Thais are at the top of the sport, and those are the only people I want to fight. Not saying that only Thais are at the top of the sport, but the people at the top are the only people I want to fight.
ก็คิดว่านานๆมาต่อยต่างประเทศทีอเมริกานี่ก็คือเป็นความใฝ่ฝันคือของผมก็คือได้มาต่อยก็ดีใจที่สุดนะครับ
You know, you go over to Thailand and you see these guys who are just straight killers in the ring, and then outside of the ring, they're the sweetest little kids you ever met.
รู้สึกดีที่ได้ชมกับนักมวยต่างชาติ
Pretty excited about it. You know, it's the first Thai I've ever fought, and supposedly the Thais are so much better than everybody else. Americans have a really terrible reputation for Muay Thai, which just drives me nuts.
The champions in the West try to compare themselves to the champions in Bangkok, but they are still very, very far behind in technique and mental strength.
It makes me train that much harder all the time.
ก็เอาเป็นว่าเดี๋ยววันที่21เดี๋ยวจะพยายามมีศิลปะแม่ไม้เมืองไทยอะไรเนี่ยเขาช่วยครับ
No matter how many fights somebody has, they never fought me. I mean, it doesn't matter how much experience somebody has over you, they've never fought you.
When Romie fights, you can't stay in your seat.
I think he was losing that fight.Those first few rounds, he was toying with me, just foot in my chest all day, you know?